डॉक्टर सुशील कुमार।
Now I would like to introduce Dr. Sushil Kumar. Presently, Dr. Sushil Kumar is an editor of Physics Journal, Journal of Nuclear Physics, Material Sciences, Radiation and Application, a refereed and index open access journal with worldwide reputed advisory board and editorial board member. Dr. Sushil Kumar is associate professor of physics. He has received his MSc degree from IIT Roorkee, formerly University of Roorkee, and PhD in nuclear physics from Punjab University, Chandigarh. His PhD work was concerned with the alpha and cluster decay studies of various nuclei from light mass region to super heavy mass region in the nuclear chart. Dr. Sushil Kumar has visited the University of Messina, Italy at the International Symposium based on the quasi-fission process in heavy ion reaction 2010, where he has delivered talk and chaired one session. In June 2014, Dr. Sushil has presented his work at JINR Dubna, Russia, being a member of first official India JINR forum. Dr. Sushil Kumar successfully organized an international conference on recent trends in the nuclear physics 2012 with support of the DST, DAE, BRNS, CSIR, UGC, and INSA. He has also published the conference proceedings in AIP, USA as an editor. He is passionate about teaching technologies and delivered many talk on it. Recently, Dr. Sushil Kumar has taken sessions on the online teaching tools for the participants of addressing challenges on online teaching learning event that was scheduled from 4th September to 10th September 2020, organized by the Human Resource Development Center, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Dr. Sushil Kumar is Deputy Dean Journals and Publications at Chitkara University Publication, Chandigarh. He is also playing managing editor role in the all other journals. Dr. Sushil Kumar set up the open journal management system for the Chitkara University publications, taking care overall its global reputation, marketing, and related components of the worldwide circulation of the journal. He supports the open access model for research publication, where the authors do not need to pay the fee to the journals for publication, they do just research. He is scientific blogger at apnifysics.com, where he shares his research and teaching experience by using the LMS. He has also created his online courses where no sign-in is required to access the content. And he has on a YouTube channel, Sushil K717 Able. More than 73,000 subscribers are following his different videos, contents, information. Thank you, sir. Please, I welcome you to the talk.
Thank you, Mr. Lally. Thank you, Professor OSKS Sastri, convener, and Professor Hong Chan, Dean and Head, Professor S.K. Soni, and Professor Dilip Verma. I am thankful to all the team who provide me this opportunity to present and share my experience with you all, and my gratitude to the Vice Chancellor of the Central University of Himachal Pradesh to share all these things. And again, sir, I am really very thankful because you gave me this opportunity at the end, and this is very important that if the end is good, so everything is good. So please bear with me, and my basically talk dedicated to the young researchers and those who are basically follow the tradition of in the research, right? Title of my presentation is Open Access Journals and Research Trend Exploration. So I will talk a little about to the Open Access Journal, and then after I will switch to the bibliometric study of the cluster radioactivity. So how basically these things are the need of the today's researcher, and how basically what are the challenges for the tomorrow. This is the overview of my presentation. So first of all, I will discuss about to the Budapest Open Access Initiative, what is that open access policy. Then after, I will discuss about to the open access journals, the type of that, and how basically one can identify that. And at the fourth point, there are something related to the open access societies and directories. And important part will remain of this presentation, that is the bibliometric analysis, and I have selected here the cluster radioactivity area of the nuclear physics. In addition to it, I will discuss about to the plan S, that is of the coalition S. You might heard about it, and if you are not aware, so I will share some point of these principles and the general checker tools, and at the end the outcome. So first of all, that what is the Budapest Open Access Initiative? That was basically one initiative taken by the European Commission and the publisher. So they basically organized a meeting, and in that meeting they decided some rule related to the open access journal and archive repository. So the first and important part into the open access journal, basically, if one have to find out the open access journal, so what are the criteria according to the Budapest Open Access Initiative, that is called BOI, that all the copyrights transferred to the author. And second thing, these copyrights should be with CC BY license attribution. This is one of the important part. And second thing, they say that these articles should be preserved, right? And for that, there are some agencies, basically repositories, to preserve the articles, and those are like LOGS, PKPPN and PortRepo. So some basically takes the charges to preserve the article, and some basically are open access. And on the other hand, the second thing comes, you might heard about to the repositories. So basically, what are the conditions for that to be open access, those repositories? You might heard about to the archive.org, everyone, those who are sitting here are aware about to the archive.org. But some of you may be familiar or not with the indiaarchive.org at the same patron or with as the archive.org. So my request to all the young researchers, before publishing the paper, you have to submit the preprint in the either into the archive or India archive. Right, so author can submit the article on open electronic archive. So that is the preprint actually of the article version. So Budapest Open Access actually give the opportunity to sign that this open access initiative, and your institution or university, basically you can search that. Now the second thing is about to the open access journals, the types of actually you might heard about that some journals are gold open access journal, some are green open access journal, hybrid, bronze, platinum, and some are black open access journal. So these are the categories basically of the open access journal. So here basically, if you are not for the young researchers, I am basically sharing the information. So if the young researchers are not aware about to the license, so I will just try to cover some part of the license that in the next slide. But here, APC means article processing charge, right? Or you can say, right? So gold open access. Gold open access journals are those journal basically, those who take the article processing charge and keep some licenses, right? That license basically allows the author to share the content or not, to rebuild or use the content or figure like that. So there are some basically limitations on that. And second type of the journal is green open access journal. Here, there is no article processing charges and not CC BY license. That is the important point. They are not taking charges, but they are basically putting your article, putting your information, putting the research into the black box, right? Not CC BY license, remember here, I will explain this thing in the next slide. And some journals are hybrid, they are also open access, some article they provide open, and some article they put behind the paywall. And some journal are bronze journal, there are some readable article, and but there are some limitations of the license. And then after platinum open access journal, there is no article processing charge and license is CC BY license, right? Platinum open access journal, in case I have given an example of our journal, that is the platinum open access journal, we are not taking article processing charge from the author, and we are providing the copyright license to the author. that is CC BY license. So author did not require to ask us to use any content of their article, of their information itself. And Black Open Access Journal, you might heard about it. So now the copyright license, what is that? So you people just visit the Creative Commons website and there you will see five, six type of license. But here the plan of to discuss is just to CC BY license. In the CC BY license, actually, what you can do, if your article is publishing with CC BY license, then the reader, and author itself are not required to take the permission from the editor and publisher, right, to use the content. They and what basically the reader can do, other researchers can do, they can use the idea, they can use the small part of that article, a figure, right, provided the condition is that one have to give the credit to the original source. This is the only condition, right, into the CC BY license. In addition to the CC BY license, there are also one like non-derivative and similar like and non-commercial ND, non-derivative, SA, similar like, alike, and NC, non-commercial, and the combination of these. So when we say that we have to put some restrictions on to the knowledge content, then some publisher editor basically they put this kind of license like CC BY NC, CC BY ND, right, and other things. So in this segment, I will basically share an idea. Basically, this is important to every researchers, right? Being a traditional researcher, so we think this is the part of the library, so we have no to think about it. So we have to actually make an awareness among the researchers that these are the things where we have to basically work. Like Center for Open Science, if you are working on a project, so you can share your article, your information, your database here, and from the Center for Open Science, you basically can find the possibility of collaboration to the other researchers, right? So you have to look all these things, and upper one like Open Access Scholarly Publisher Association and Open Access Switchboard. These are basically the same agencies, or OSPA basically. Open Access Switchboard is the sister branch of the OSPA, right? So every publisher basically have to follow the some guidelines to be open access, and according to that there are some agencies and there are some repository where you can basically update your work. And here you can see the CoAR, this Confederation of Open Access Repositories, are basically part of the OpenAIR. So OpenAIR is the most bigger one, repository of the world, where you can see all the open access things. So just providing you an idea that you have seen all these things, directory of open access journals, you might have everyone. Here, Plan S. Plan S actually is very important to everyone, and especially for the Indian researchers, because the European researchers have followed and following all these things. And now you basically, since last 5-6 years, you might heard about to the hearing about to the open access. Why? What is the reason behind to that? That reason actually behind of that is about this Plan S. This Plan S is very important, and there are some 10 principles according to that every publisher and journal have to follow to be the open access and to get the grant actually from the funding agency, right? So what are the details of it? Let's see. And what is correlation? So here in a simple way you can see that I hope that it will be visible at the big screen, but might be problem into the mobile. So on 4th September 2018, actually, a group of national research funding organizations, that European Commission and European Research Council, they basically announce a kind of some principle that what should be basically, as you know, that before I discuss all these things, The point is that we are the researchers, we are working hard to publish one research article. It takes 3 to 6 months and more than that, then we publish. And when we publish it in a journal where our Indian also, our Indian researcher also have to pay to read that information, right? So the great people, the good people basically are coming forward and they are saying that knowledge should be available to each and everyone, because we are taking the public fund and this fund basically coming from the public. So it should be basically the knowledge which is coming from that source that should be available to each and everyone. So this is the idea behind to the plan. So with effect from 2021, all scholarly publications on the results from research funded by public or private grants provided by national, regional and international research councils and funding bodies must be published in open access journals. So on open access platforms or made immediately available through open access repository without embargo period. So this is very important thing that you have to be aware, and especially young researchers. So what are basically those 10 points? So here my request to all the young researchers, please visit this website and read carefully all these coalition as 10 points. And everyone basically is following to them. And this is the reason. This is the reason every publisher, every big publisher has switched their journals into the open access journals, right? And because they because of this reason, they are saying that we are green open access journal or gold open access journal or platinum open access journal. Because the funding agencies of the European country have decided clear that they are providing to fund to the researcher since 2021 if they will publish their article into the open access journals. Right, so many countries basically have followed it and following all these things. So here at the 10th number, I will bring out your attention what they are saying, and you have to decide it at your end. The funders commit that when assessing research outputs during funding decisions, they will value the intrinsic merit of the work and not consider the publication channel, its impact factor or other journal matrices, like I am saying openly, it H index, I index, how many times basically an article is downloaded, how many times basically it is shared on the social media, like that. So these are the things that comes into the journal metrics, that how many article basically are published. So with the international group, and who are the collaborator, who are the funding agency, these are the things basically comes into the general matrices. So they are saying that we will not focus on the journal matrices or the impact factor of the journal, we will focus the individual article merits, right? So this is the point, right? And many of you are aware that impact factor basically is to just the journal quality, not the individual article. And here you can see that there is a journal checker tool which is provided by the Plan S. There are three sections. The number one is the journal, and the second one is the funding agency, and the third one is the institution. So I have taken here just a simple example of our journal. I put here the ISSN number 2321-8649. When we will type the ISSN number of any journal, that journal basically will be listed here, and you can see in the similar way. And at the second my funder box, you can basically search your Indian agencies, your European, American, and other basically funding agency. You just put here either the research word or national word, you will see a number of the possibility of the funders for different. And at the third point, actually I have taken here Punjab University, and you can type here if your university is a research university, you and that have ROR, a number basically which is given. So type here any university, any institution, and you can see all that thing. Now, the thing is, suppose a person from this Punjab University or Chitkara University or from the Central University of Himachal Pradesh take the international grant from the French National Research Agency. French National Research Agency has already signed the plan S. So according to that, their policy, the fundee basically need to publish their article in a open access journal. So they will put the information of the journal into the journal section. And now we will run this tool from here equal to, and it will say us to that this combination is complying the plan as policy or no, right? So this is the point. So journal checker tool basically, through this journal checker tool, one can identify that a particular journal basically complying the conditions of the open access policy of the funder or not, right? So here our journal basically satisfy most of the foreign funding agencies. Right now Indian DST and DBD is not signed the plan S, but they are trying to bring out the open access journal. One thing I want to say in addition to this one, and that is directly related to the impact factor misconception. So most of the time the people basically, I am not the against of this of these things, but this is my responsibility to share the information with the young researchers and those who are traditional researchers, this kind of information, right? So if you have any question you can ask, but my purpose is just to share these things. DORA is a very important agency that basically the people are basically trying to bring out some other parameter to judge the research instead of H index parameter, impact parameter, right? So in a short, I will say this thing about to the DORA, and you can also read these things about sfdora.org. And now in our case, we are publishing 9 open access journals through this publication house, and I'm taking care of that. As Mr. Lalit informed you that in addition to the teaching and other activity, I have learned number of the things related to the journal. I have set up it myself, open journal management system, and learning new things and implementing many technology into this one. We had started our publication in 2013, and we being member of the COP, official member since 2019, and in 2020 I have managed all the policy of all the journals according to the plan S, because I was aware through the Twitter in 2018 that these things are coming. So slowly I have developed all those things, and in 2020 I basically followed all those things. And in 2021, actually you have seen that we are just publishing the PDF file of the article, and nowadays actually I am looking for the XML file and other format of the publishing. So this is very important, and some of you may have faced the problem, problem that we have only the Word template, not LaTeX. So my request, those who are involved right now, if they can design a style file for us, so it will be a great thing. And in 2022, my purpose, my target is that our journal should be listed in a good database. And now this is very important information you will see, and you have to basically find out it through the search engine. Have you heard earlier about to the f1000research.com? If not, just visit the approach of the publishing. Right now, what is the approach of the publishing? You know that you submit the article, and then after you basically observe some points that is given by the reviewers, and you send it to the editor. So this kind of approach you have seen, but here that is totally different. That is the open access research approach that you will see here. And this basically this publishing authenticity of it is basically managed by the planners. So I am maybe little fast because I have to share some point with you. So please bear with me, ladies and gentlemen. And this is the output of the open access journals according to the Springer. Right, what they are saying, if the articles are open access, they download it from their database 4 times more, and their citation increases by 1.6 times, and their arithmetic attention has increased 2.5 times. Arithmetrics and plum x is y. You might there is no basically part of that arithmetrics and plum x, but I want to share this information also with you that in addition to the citation at the present time, this is very important that where and how your article is shared on the social media. And first and most important is Twitter, then after the Facebook and Reddit. You have to see all these things and share your research article instead of taking the link on the social media. You just share your article from the journal website. There are these kind of tools, social media, and you share please your article through the journal website instead of copy the link and then share on your Facebook or on Twitter board, right? So just share your article from the journal website. MBO Press working principle. Why I'm taking here this information, because MBO is taking charges for the open access article from 3,000 euro to 5,000 euros in different journals. So you can imagine that if all the journals are open access journal and if they are taking the article processing charges, does Indian researchers are capable to pay the amount into the good journal? So there are some questions related to it, and they are open, so people are discussing about it at different platforms. And India basically has started to one nation one subscription approach, when all the journals are basically are approaching to the open access, towards the open access initiative. That means all the subscribed journal are moving towards the open access journal. So there is a question, but maybe there will be some different policy of the government. So I'm not commenting right now. And this is the point for the nuclear research community, and this bibliometric analysis and cytometric analysis also together. I am discussing about to the cluster radioactivity, that is the part of the nuclear physics, and most mainly I have seen here many presentations related to the nuclear physics, and especially some people you discuss about the cluster radioactivity also, in particular. So I could say some point with you, but before that, before sharing this information with you all at today, you might heard that our guide and our supervisor, everyone basically, what they do, they just provide some research articles to the researchers, those who are fresh into the PhD program. And then scholar basically read those paper, try to understand all those things. But here you can see into the blue box, I have taken 2,152 articles and analyzes all those using the R and Google Sign-E program. Right, these are 1865 articles, and conference paper are 241, review article are 46, and this data is taken from the Scopus database. Right, so there are keyword plus that I will define what are the keywords, authors keyword, and the period of the this database is taken from the 1990 to the 2019. Why I did not select the 2020, because I have to publish this paper, so all the, I am not sharing all the information in advance, but we'll share some important thing that will be definitely useful to the young researchers if they want to conclude something about to the their research area. I am just using the cluster radioactivity term, right, into the nuclear physics area. So these are the data and how basically I have collected it, that is collected from the Scopus. this is the three field plots, and into the first column I have taken consider here the author's name, those who are involved into the cluster radioactivity area, and at the second column you can see that the keywords basically, and at the third segment I have considered here the name of the journal. So these branches basically, what they define? They define a connection between the author, keywords and the journal, right? So here, first of all, you can see a big box for the Professor Santosh KP. Professor KP Santosh, why basically you can see here the big box or small box? It depends on that how many number of the articles with these keywords are available in account of that particular researchers. So Professor K.B. Santosh, Professor D.N. Poynaro, Grace Crew, ACOR, WSI, W. Grena, Professor R.K. Gupta ji, and Dr. Jain, and there are so many, Professor M.K. Sharma, and D. Nee, Professor Dr. R. Kumar, Professor M. Balasubramaniam, and all these, and all the cluster radioactivity and alpha decay people are aware about all about to these authors. I have considered here only 20. So 20 authors and 20 keywords and the most probable journal with these keywords and authors. So you can see the combination of these authors with the keywords. So right. So I'm just giving an idea, and into the second picture you can see that I have focused on the keyword. So alpha decay. Right, so here in alpha decay you can see that the width of the branch in both sides, towards the author and towards the journal, which journal is favorable for a particular keyword. So indirectly I am saying that if you have to publish an article and you have some kind of this kind of information, you can judge that this journal may be favorable to your article in addition to the journal finder, right? So there are so many things, not only one. So here I have just selected the alpha decay word, and then after the concern, author and the name of the journal. Here I have basically highlighted the here Professor M.K. Sharma, Manoj sir, and the basically width of the branch move towards the fission keyword, right? And then after spontaneous fission and super heavy nuclei, and then thin one is the alpha decay. So now this is the study basically, those who are funding agencies and library people, bibliometric study, and the journal also do it for their future perspective, that how basically a research area is growing and who are the researchers and who basically, there are so many things, my dear friends, and here you can take an idea. And this idea you will guide for the future research, right? So in a specific domain, if you are using a specific keywords, that keyword basically decide your contribution into that particular area, into the domain, when the people will study all the research, all the publications, right? And this happens when the people do provide the funding and at different levels. So here I have highlighted the journal of International Journal of Modern Physics E, and you can see the branch of that and the width of that, right? So you can see the this journal of Modern Physics E, the maximum width is at alpha decay and half life. So you are you people are more intelligent than me, and you can understand the idea what I'm saying here. And here again, I have taken this side, in the left side, the name of institution, and at the center, the name of the author, and the third column is given to the keywords. So the first out of all these institutions, you can see the Punjab University and its width, and its width basically approach to the professor, late Professor R.K. Gupta ji, and then after Professor Noor sir, Kumar Air, Rajkumar sir, and Aiko, and this W. Grena, and Professor M. Balasubramaniam, and Professor W. Said. So you can see the collaboration also together, and whom basically is the main leader of that institution. So you can judge all these things, and then after and this thing this is very confidential actually. Those who are established journal, reputed journal, they judge the researcher by this way, and then they approach to them, and then things happens, many things happens into the publication behind the curtain. So I'm not sharing all those confidential thing here, but I am sharing the information that how basically the things run behind the curtain. And here again I have highlighted Kannur University of Professor K.P. Santosh. While the university is dependent, and you have seen that Professor K.P. Santosh, I am not pointing out it in a different way, but I am saying that your institution basically there is no collaboration of with other authors, so you are working independently, and because of that reason this is the point, this is the reflection. So one have to be basically collaborate with other authors and other institutions, and these things basically decide that what is going on into a particular field and with particular research researcher and the institutions. Right here I have taken the country name, and then after the author and the institutions name. So you can see here India, Ukraine, Iran just has started, and other things. Okay, my dear friends, this thing may be new for you, and I have only 2-3 minutes, so I will just try to compile all these things. That basically this is a this analysis provide a network. These are basically are known as clusters. So where is the a big cluster? The bigger size means that author is dominant author and has a collaboration type of group and institution, you can see. So there are many clusters here, you can see, of the professor, late professor R.K. Gupta sir, and one orders cluster group, and other either this side from the and Italy group and German group, and you can see right in the second slide. I will focus on it only, Professor Gupta sir, and here you can see all the co-authors basically, and Royer, Denshaw, Beck, Hoffman, Singh, Prusa, Bir Bikram, Dr. Bir Bikram Singh, and here and into the next one you can see clearly that and dot size basically define that impact of the author, right? So here you can see the dot of dot size of this one related to that particular field and related to that person as a co-author. So there is a different kind of color also I have observed, but no problem. So this is I have shared here two named authors. So one is the Professor N. Balasubramaniam, and second is the Professor Munoz Sharma sir. I have taken here two clusters of you and your co-authorship and network with other authors, and this is the most relevant sources. The first one is the PRC, and second is Nuclear Physics A, and where basically the article published most of them from the cluster radioactivity, and these are most relevant authors into this cluster radioactivity area. And here top authors production over the period, small dot means number of the articles, and big dot that and big dot and heavy dot a dark dot that means more contribution in that particular year of that particular author. So I have highlighted here again some Indian authors and their contribution year wise into the cluster radioactivity area, and the keywords they had used into their articles. And again this thing I have shown into the three plot, and here corresponding authors country. SCP the blue one, and MCP is the red one. SCP is the single country publication, MCP is the multiple country publications. So these are the idea or reflection of corresponding authors country actually. So in India you can see the most basically the person from a single country publication. That means overall, India basically remain in this field at top, being in a corresponding author and published along with some other country also, you can see. But most of the time remain a local Indian, right? So Iran earlier, there were no MCP into the Iran section, but nowadays I am looking at this red part of that. That means that nowadays Iran had also started to publish into the cluster addictivity region, similarly in Turkey and Canada. So, most cited countries, you can see the China into the cluster radioactivity area, and then after India, USA, Germany, Romania, like this. Most relevant words, basically many times I share the information with you all related to the keywords, that why these keywords are important. So here you can see that alpha decay, decay, super heavy nuclear cluster decay, all basically terms we use, but which keywords we have to use in our article, there is just some meaning of that. That reflection you can see here, and here I want to show you one important thing, that which keyword you have to use in your research article, or using in your research article, and according to that, up to the 2019, the what is the trend of the keywords, alpha decay at the top, and then after super heavy nuclei and half life together, spontaneous fission at that. At the third position, right? So this, by this way, you can see the trend year wise of the keywords, that that how basically a research article is publishing. And keyword plus is what, this is a technical term, and here I have written the definition of it. So this is also important, and we also observe it when we do the study. Shastri sir, I had a request, so please give me 2-3 minutes more. I have past the time, and this country
sure.
And you can see here the country collaboration map, and you can take the idea, actually when you are working in a research domain, you have to be very alert, right? That who basically is the main author, who is the dominant author, what are the keywords, and how basically we are using the keywords. So when someone analyzes the specific domain of a research, so we basically can show our contribution into that. This is also equally important in addition to the sharing the published information. And I have shown here that it does not matter that where you are publishing, it does not matter. So here are these things, and I have actually organized one conference, sorry, a school. And in that school, I have provided this idea 2 years back. And we basically had published an article that was basically taken. And then that time, the data was taken from the SciMago JR website only. You can just imagine the idea is, the data is taken from the SciMago JR website. Not from Scopus, not from the Web of Science. And I had just guide to them, and they published this article. They compare the output of two different areas, right, with two different countries. And you can see here, the if you have to see the matrices, that this kind of things basically publish, and people recognize it. And at the outcome, I will say that to the young researchers especially, that this is very important. You have to publish because you people are working hard, and that information is not bound behind the paywall, right? It should be available to everyone. So you have to publish into the open access journals, right? And check the journal quality, everything you have to check. There are some parameters of that I have listed many times. Second challenge is for us, for the for our country, for our researchers. We always blame that our people are doing this kind of practice or that kind of practice, but we are not providing all these tools and information to them so they can manage the things. So and now it is challenge if all the journals are open access journal and they are taking a article processing charges. So how basically we people will publish number of the articles? So that is challenge. And one of the important thing, basically, most of you are aware of that impact, and the H index is not only the criteria to judge the research merit, And at number four, a review and analysis of domain specific published paper and exploration of new emerging area by using such kind of techniques instead of reading 4 by 10 papers in 2-3 months. Well, if you need, I can help anyone and will provide you the program so you can analyze the data. I hope that every institutions and the representative of the every institutions who are attending this conference, they basically easily can get the Scopus and Web of Science data to explore their field in depth and make a strategy for the future. So thank you so much, sir. And these are the information that I want to share with the young researchers especially. And I am thankful once again, Professor Shastri sir, to give me this opportunity. I don't know what I justify the presentation or not, but this is the point from my side. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a very wonderful talk, and actually, you see, the importance of this subject is growing because the Undergraduate University Grants Commission, UGC, has now introduced a core compulsory paper on research publication ethics. And for all your information, Dr. Sushil is the most wanted resource person on this field. Okay, and we are extremely grateful to Dr. Sushil for actually giving 3 lectures to our students. All 3 of them I've heard. They are so much eye openers. And many times, because we only look for 2 or 3 journals, we are not even aware actually, you know, because everybody in nuclear physics will look towards Physical Review C or Journal of Physics G. Yeah. And after that, maybe 2-3 more journals, like, you know, European Journal of Physics A or some such thing. But otherwise, we have no idea that there are so many variety of journals, and all of them are actually okay. Luckily, they don't take payment, but they are closed journals, they're not open. And whereas there are so many other open access journals which actually give us good clarity. Sir, one or two questions I wanted to ask.
Yes.
One was this archive, for example. Yes. They do not allow anybody to upload. And so I thought, okay, India archive is good. And yes, we recently uploaded a paper on India archive. And some message keeps coming that, you know, your paper needs to be first done. It's more than a month. And till now, the paper has not been, one article got put up. Another article in nuclear physics, till now it has not come on India archive for people to look at it.
Okay, I will ask her to the concerned person. So
when they say archive, see, for example, in archive.org, you want to publish a paper in one particular, you want to put your paper in one particular field, they will say you have to get some permission from at least recommendations. Again, here also, these kind of things are coming. So my suggestion is you yourself start on archive because you are doing such wonderful work. And at least within India, we can put our own work on on the website, and then everybody can get the knowledge. Okay, later on the peer review happens, and there is a lot of change after the peer review, there's no doubt. But at least our initial output can be available easily to the Indian audience.
Definitely, sir. I will consider this suggestion.
And thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And we do hope that any help that you need from us to make your journal really listed in Scopus, we will be happy to do. Definitely. Right? Okay. Now I request the audience to please share their comments and suggestions. Yeah. Manoj, sir.
Okay. Yeah. I have 2 small questions.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Sushil, you had given a good lecture, so congratulations for that.
You
mentioned that publication in open access journals is better because you have more download citations, etc. But the problem is most of them, they are not listed in JC or SCI, etc. So yes, what is your comment on that?
Here I have already pointed out that these are the matrices only to just the journal only, not only the article, and most of the researcher, young researcher and traditional researchers are not aware and made it a parameter. And our Indian system actually is following to that. If we will publish in impact factor journal, only then we will reputed researchers and all the things. But in case of open access journal, thing is what? That Why again I am putting one question here, why those people basically are making their journal open access, those were earlier the subscription based journal, right? We have to understand it, sir.
Even nature has gone towards golden open access recently, just a month ago.
Yeah, the fund basically European Commission have the funds, providing the fund and making the policy. When they are providing fund to the fundee, that they have to publish their article only in open access journal, irrespective to the impact factor, H index, and other things, and indexing into the scopus of Web of Science.
Okay.
I don't want to say some more thing related.
Okay, that's fine. Second question is that. You mentioned that you will apply for SCI Scopus listing by 2022. So my question is, what are the requirements and what makes you keep on waiting till 2022 and not apply now?
I have applied earlier also, but due to some other, not some other, only one other, what they did, they published actually a duplicate paper in our journal.
Yeah, I think this one should be an eye opener to all the researchers. Yeah. See, unless until we really publish in our own journals, our journals will not go into Scopus. So I think we all should encourage and try to publish our work in this kind of journals, so that they'll also, after all, what is listed in Scopus, because they have been for very long publishing from, I think, maybe 50s or 60s or 70s, so they are already in Scopus. And the new journals can also come into Scopus, or can come into really the top rated journals only when we publish into them. And that's what actually Chinese do. See, today Chinese physics C is topping. It has grown by 275% in the last 1 year, its impact factor. It has gone beyond 5 now, because all of them publish in their own country within their own journals.
Yes.
This is something I think we all should try to take it up very seriously and try to promote our own journals.
Sir, what is database actually? They have a specific target, basically target, you can say, the like now we all people here are of the nuclear physics, and we are targeted audience. So this is a database. They basically say they just see the quality of the article journal, and then after they say that we will share this kind of information with our community. So you will get more citation, and this is the game actually. I don't want to say anything and anymore about it.
Any other questions or suggestions, comments, please?
Dr. Shastri, I would like to ask a couple of questions.
Yes.
I mean, I'm not a person fully aware of, but what I understand is, like, when we talk about one concern is actually the reputation, right? And my understanding is reputation depends greatly on the reputation of the referees. And how does that system work? Because I also occasionally get something to be referred, but how do a journal choose the referees? And beyond that, I want to ask, suppose, say, UGC or somebody, if they create a panel of referees known to all, or a pool of referees from the institutes like ICERS, IITs, and Central University, many or major researchers, and suppose if we have kind of criteria like the things have to be, the articles have to be reviewed by a panel that is approved or some such, is there such a thing? Or I mean, I'm putting it very vaguely. Will it improve the reputation or the quality of the journals? Because now one concern, everyone wants to publish in the open only, definitely no doubt about it. But people are slightly concerned, whether it will be really visible or whether will people take it seriously or not. Because people go for the Elsevier or other, things, because they consider that, it will be taken seriously, right? Every researcher wants that to be referred. So is there anything, any such fundamental things whether we can do to improve the quality and finally the reputation?
Sir, there is one thing that earlier conferences we basically publishing the that report basically which was not published anywhere. And that poster and oral presentations, in that oral and poster presentation, expert people basically ask the question list. And from there, we young researchers basically get the feedback that we have to do these things. So the first criteria of the review comes through the conferences. But what the people are doing, the people are basically, and the practice basically has been started due to the API and other things. So we are diluting the research. One problem we are publishing in a 3 and 4 different way in different journals. So this is the thing that there are so many things basically. So according to your question and as per your question, the first thing is that we have to organize the conferences frequently. And we have to request every researcher, especially young researchers, that they have to come with new idea and new research problem instead of already published problem to share into the conference. So by this way, the expert people like this in this conference and other conferences, there are some experts, those who ask the question, and then that time they had to ask and understand their duty to bring out the quality into the research. And young researchers also have to observe that if they are asking the question and making a good discussion, that is only for the quality of the article and the research. Because you know that if I'm working into the cluster activity, so there are many big people are here. If I will put any idea of that, many expert people can ask that question. So this is the first thing that we have to create at our end. That is very important. And we have to stop republishing, representing the paper into the conference. And genuine person basically have to review those things. This is one of the point. And this point is I'm asking, sharing in general, not for a specific or anywhere. This is general, according to your question, Ajit sir. And second thing is like that I had started the journal in 2013. Earlier, the only my collaborators and people who knows me that were publishing the article. And now people had basically when some foreign country Mexican Radiation Society had started to publish and they are getting good citation of their journal and our effort. So people had started to recognize the journal nowadays. So we had to understand that my point to say that we have to recognize our efforts also. We have not to criticize that Sushil or any other person is publishing. We have to basically improve the thing which is going at present. So if you you can see the journal technically and at other point, so you can see. So we have to, because I am not expert in every area, so I have some links, so I just ask to those people that this is the paper which has been submitted in my journal. You are requested, please give me your feedback and like that. So I just randomly ask to those people, right? And take their services, scientific services, and they, because of their contribution, today's journal basically is highlighted in different platforms. So we have to see all these things together and we have to sit together for these kind of things.
Actually, what I was trying to tell you was not only this journal, all Indian journal. I was just seeing now reviewing a journal, somebody reviews it for you, but he's not bound to do that. Suppose say if you have a system somewhere officially under you something, suppose it becomes a part of the job and you have a panel or a large group of experts doing that, and suppose journals are choosing from that, so that itself gives a stamp of a kind of like authenticity. I'm just seeing whether you people should move some such idea to the authorities or our higher ups, and is it worth doing? I was just commenting on that. I have no idea. Yeah.
That would be good actually. See, like for example, Dr. Sushil showed in his talk how Professor Manoj's network is and what are his main fields of now. Similarly, what is Professor Balasubramanian's network and what are the kinds of keywords? So whenever you get a particular article, and so every researcher in the country, at least the top professors and those who have got, they all can be actually clearly identified what is their topics and all that. So any journal which gets a particular article, it's not just Chitkara journal, I'm talking any journal in India. That's what I think Ajit sir is trying to emphasize. Yeah, right. automatically it will go into one of those groups only. Say, for example, now, Journal of Pramana wants to publish a paper on cluster radioactivity. It should automatically look towards Professor Manoj or Professor Balasubramanian or Professor, those who are in the field. It should automatically show these are the people who are experts within the country who are capable of reviewing this article. That kind of information is possible because I am seeing in your network, in your slides, that such kind of effort is very much possible to identify the real experts in the field. And automatically it can be. And then what he says is like, just like we have this many hours to be given, similarly, at least they should review two papers in a month or at least, if not more, or if they get, they should be ready to, at least. And that way, what happens is like, the speed also will go up. Right now, the review takes very long, actually. You send a paper, after 1.5 months or 2 months, we get. That's why I think sometimes, our journals, our papers do get delayed also. So that's a very good idea, actually. And I think
it's very possible. Cannot, compel a referee to do it quickly. But suppose there is a system which tells, okay, this is also part of your job, you
have to do it. Exactly. Then automatically, the time period can come down.
Right.
Anyway, I think this discussion can go on and on. We will thank the speaker for his wonderful elucidate talk. And I think it really is needed for all the researchers to know what is needed to be done for the country's progress. And we are thankful to you, sir.